Hello, Internet. Welcome to the iGamer Podcast. This is episode 10 of my playthrough of Bioshock Infinite. Episode 9 ended rather abruptly after... Oh, son of a fucking... God,
who's
God damn it.
Find this person?
Daisy Fitzroy.
She's either a great
well,
hero or the
this
worst
is
of
actually now episode 9, because I have
she's
to repeat a bunch
airship.
Of stuff. That's really annoying. So all of a sudden, my game started glitching out. Nothing looked right. Yeah, it just... It was not cool. People were looking like
the truth
whole,
is I don't have a lot
yeah,
of
it just,
time
it was,
for
it was
all
not
that
pleasant.
Prophecy nonsense.
So,
I tell you, belief is just a commodity.
I'm gonna run through this quickly.
Comstock, well, he does produce,
just,
but like
just,
any
move on, move on the story a little bit. I'm trying to go and see
lords.
Mr. Fink.
You see,
and
one does
there
not
are no jobs available, so I have to find
a
way to break in.
Alone. No, sir.
And infusions are always good. Salts are always good.
A Fink hammer and Fink's hand to swing it. He needs me, lest he soil his own.
Welcome to Fink Industries recruitment.
There are
Fink
no
are
jobs available.
Any
all right, cool.
You hear that?
Cool.
All
right, let's find another way in.
Illegally. Let's look for another way in. It's locked.
Break in for me.
There.
Piece
over
of cake.
There. A service elevator. It should take us down to vision.
And get ourselves killed in the bargain.
Let's deal with that guy right now. Take it!
Got
give it.
It
to me! Give it to me! Alright. Bam! Oh, come on! Alright. Whoa! No! Ow! Ow, there was lots of pain there. It's okay, because everyone throws out food here, it seems.
Interesting.
Ooh. Cash bag for cash monies.
Found some money.
Ooh, money, you say?
Catch, Mr. DeWitt.
She looks very angry with me.
Gunsmith Chen Lin, wanted for known connections to the outlaw Daisy Fitzroy.
Looks like our guy's drawn attention.
That's
locked.
Not good, is it?
Elizabeth!
Really? That little old lock.
It's done.
Alright. Miss good at picking locks. Just because I'm not as good at you at picking locks as you are, doesn't mean you have to be all sniper about it. Any machine. Clip increase for the carbine. Yeah. And lockpick. Hey, Slade. Press that dare button. I love how I hit in the middle of that, and all of a sudden that worked.
Booker. It's Slate's locker. He must have worked here. This is my mother's diary. Why would Slate have it? My husband claims the child was created from whole cloth by divine will. I am a believer, but I am not a fool. His bastard shall not be raised under this roof. My mother. She had me locked in that tower.
Elizabeth.
Your mother is horrible.
City. Please.
Alright. Well, that's not a lot of carbide ammo. Hopefully that survives me the entire time. Okay. Alright, so the first time I got to this point, my graphics started going all haywire. Hopefully they last this time. People weren't looking like people anymore. So far so good though. I have no idea what was going on last time.
It's the bee! Have you ever seen a bee on vacation? Have you ever seen a bee take a sick day? Well, my friends, the answer is no. So I say, bee... the bee! Bee!
Oh. That's not concerning at all.
Hello?
Mr. DeWitt?
Yes?
Hold for Mr. Fink, please.
What's going on?
DeWitt, Fink here. Listen, my boy, we've had our eye on you, and I can tell you right now that you are our top candidate.
Yeah.
My associate, Mr. Flambeau, will help you with anything you need.
What the hell was that?
I have no idea.
He seems oddly pleased to make your acquaintance.
Okay. All right. Why'd you have to stop the elevator?
Well, the man's got an ego.
Jesus. Really does. Wow. Definitely missed that when my graphics were glitching out, that's for sure.
Mr. DeWitt, welcome to Finkton. You'll find a variety of supplies here that should see you through your visit.
What does Mr. Fink want with us?
Excuse me, miss, but Mr. Fink's interest is strictly in the gentleman.
But why?
So sorry, young miss. But any questions regarding the gentleman's application should be taken up with Mr. Fink directly.
Huh.
Does this strike you as good news? Doesn't strike me as good news. What do you think? Head to the gunsmith or scavenge supplies by that clock shop?
15 minutes. 15 minutes now, bid 14. We give me 14.
10.
10 minutes bid, now 10. We give me 9.
9. I bid 9.
9 minutes bid, now 9. We give me 8. 9 minutes bid, now 9.
8.
8 minutes bid, now 8.
7 and a half.
7 and a half.
6 minutes and 15 seconds.
6 minutes and 5.
5 minutes 50. I can do 5 and 50.
5 and 50. I said 5 and 50. Anyone lower than 5 and 50? Cool.
Huh. So they bid on work.
We need a pipe fitter here. Crimp a pipe on Pearl Street. Starting bid of 20 minutes. Can I get 19?
18.
18 minutes bid.
I guess that's
18.
How long you get paid for.
17 minutes bid. 17.
Here it is. I was born dead.
Gunsmith.
I hear what it is people are saying.
Interesting. Okay. So now I know where to go.
We have to work 16 hours a day. No, let's be clear. I would like nothing more than to shorten your work day. But the fact is, I simply can't. Why not? Well, I can sum it up for you in one word. Morality. You see, my friends, the idol...
Here's some cash. Cash.
Thanks. From a man's hand. What goes in its place? Whiskey, women, and dice. And I, for one.
Alright, let's see what they got here for the carbide. Sniper rifle, machine gun, volley gun, nothing. Okay. Sniper rifle, fire rate, shotgun, reload rate, volley gun, shotgun, RPG, machine gun. That's always a good one. Factory entrance, all right, and the gunsmith. Let's see what we got.
I have a pressing need to speak to this so-called false shepherd, stirring up so much trouble. We got enough problems without this damn fool shooting up the city and blaming it all on the Vox. Though if he's amiable, yeah, he might be just the fellow we need for our immediate concerns.
All right, so apparently they have their eye on me. I don't know whether to be happy about that or not. All right. All right, guys, episode 11 coming up next.